Pieces of a Woman is an upcoming Netflix drama directed by Kornél Mundruczó and written by Kata Wéber, and it stars Vanessa Kirby and Shia LaBeouf. Pieces of a Woman ended up winning the Coppa Volpi for Best Actress at the Venice Film Festival for Vanessa Kirby, who was also in another great film that I'll be talking about in the future. But Pieces of a Woman, what a film, what a stunning, beautiful film this is. Based on a real life event, on a real life tragedy that happened to the director and the writer, who were partners, this film explores a woman and her husband. They're going to have a new baby, she's pregnant, and something truly terrible happens to them. And then you experience a tale of grief, but told in a very unconventional way. Vanessa Kirby and Shia LaBeouf, they deliver probably the best performances in their career, relatively young careers in a way, but still, they are terrific in this film. The way the characters are written, they go to unexpected places. You see Vanessa Kirby was very cold, was very depressed, but in a very inner way. You can feel the rage of what happened inside of her. Rage against herself, rage against other people. It's a powerful performance. But then you have Shia LaBeouf, who's the more vulnerable of the two, who's showing the most emotions in his performance. And the way he changes and shifts throughout the movie just to find some sort of, just to come to grips with what happened in the first part of the film. They are terrific, truly probably my favorite performances of the year so far. And add to that a tremendous supporting cast. You got Ellen Burstyn, Molly Parker, Benny Safdie, Sarah Snook, just like mwah, one of the best ensembles of the year. And damn, what a film! Mundruczó is an Hungarian director who's more famous for a film called White God from 2014, I think, from Cannes. And he makes a kind of cinema that some people really don't like, because in a way I can agree, because it's very obvious, thematically, narratively. There are some metaphors here and there that are just like, okay, I exactly know what that represents, I exactly know what that means. It's not an inherently bad thing. I do like that, and I do have that as well in some of my short films. But boy, there comes a point. This film would have been probably my favorite of the year if it weren't for the last 15 minutes, because it's just a little too long. Everything up until that point is heartbreaking, it's powerful. Cinematography, it's incredible use of Steadicam and handheld shots. Like, the first part of the film is a long 30-minute take that's just like, oh Jesus, please stop. Like, the way it builds tension into the viewers, it's outstanding. And the journey those characters go through, incredible. And there comes a point where it just could have ended and should have ended, but it doesn't. It just keeps it from being absolutely incredible in my eyes. But still, that doesn't negate everything that came beforehand. And the ending itself, it's fine. But boy, I absolutely love this film, and I found it to be very important. Many of those films at the festival tackle the subject of gender roles, gender identity, how men should act or women should act, and this truly perfectly embodies the nature of grief, the role of mother, the role of woman in society, as well as that of the man and of the husband. I'm really excited this is coming to Netflix. I don't know when, probably closer to award season in January or February, just to get a lot of hype, but be on the lookout for this one, because it's easily one of the best films of the year, and the performances alone make this worth a watch, and a powerful story as well. But still, guys, are you interested in watching Pieces of a Woman? Tell me in the comments below. Thanks for watching, like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.